Hi everybody, it's Carolina. I have a mini haul to do today, and I also have a big ticket item that was many months in the making. Let me give you a little bit of a backstory on the big ticket item. I'm gonna get that out of the way first. Well, I'm engaged, and I have been for a little over a year now. I got engaged on my birthday last year, and I had my ring for a very long time. And a couple of months ago, I lost it. I actually lost it at a convention, like a bridal convention, and I lost it because I was losing weight. I've lost a lot of weight since last year, May of last year, and I knew that I had to change it. I knew that I had to get it resized, and I didn't. And I bought these little, like, these little clear attachment pieces for rings, and I thought it would work until I can get it resized because I wanted to keep losing weight until I got to the size that I was comfortable with, or that I, my goal, you know, size to be. And I thought that I could, you know, hold out and you know, start wearing it again with that little clip thing, because I actually took it off for a really long time, and then I started wearing it again with that little clip thing. Well, I went to a bridal convention, and in the hustle and bustle and looking at everything and holding bags and all this stuff, I must have lost it somewhere. And I felt, I don't know how to explain how that feeling that, oh my God, somebody just died almost. And oh, I'm so sorry guys, if you guys hear a lot of noise in the background, that's because my washer is going off and I don't have my own makeup room, so this is where I do my video. So I lost my ring, and we had insurance on it, but the insurance that we had on it was actually a minimum coverage insurance. It wasn't the insurance for the full amount that was estimated, the, you know, estimated insurance value of the ring. So what we ended up doing, my insurance is amazing, and we ended up, what they ended up doing is giving us a diamond that was equal value but a little bit better quality, and all we had to do is pay for the setting. Well, the setting that I had originally had, it was a little bit more expensive when I went to go get it, and since it was a little bit more expensive, I kind of took it upon myself to upgrade my ring, since I figured, you know what, as much as this sucks, losing my ring sucks so much, this is an opportunity, I'm gonna look at it as an opportunity to maybe get something that I wanted a little bit more. And so with my fiance's blessing, because Lord love him, he's been great about this whole thing, I picked out, me and my best friend went, and we looked at rings and stuff, and she helped me pick out one, I think it's one of the prettiest rings ever. So my major haul is my engagement ring, which I just got about 2 days ago right now. And this is the engagement ring that I currently have now. And it is, it's just me. I don't even know how to explain it. Yeah, I have a scar in this hand, which makes this like the ugliest like hand to model rings ever. But I just love this ring. It's very me. At least that's what my coworker said. She looked at it and she said, "That's you. That ring right there is so you. It looks delicate, because I always have, like, you know, kind of whimsical, kind of dainty pieces for the most part." She just thinks that it's like so me, and I happen to agree. I absolutely love it. My fiance loves it too. So yeah, that is my major haul. I'm very excited, very happy that I finally got this out of the way. We are not planning on having a really big wedding, so this is kind of like the major ticket item that we're doing. So yeah, I want to say 5 or 6 months to pay off the ring so I can actually have it, and I'm very happy. I really love it, and I just wanted to share that with you, because I've been, you know, this has like been the last couple of days, it's like, oh my God, my ring! I went to Walgreens, and I actually got a couple of things that I've been really wanting to get for a really long time. Well, one, I got a new nail file. I got one of the big ones so I can take it with me. It's just a regular emery board nail file from Sally Hansen. It has all these butterflies. I actually have a toe separator for painting my nails in this pattern, so I was like, oh, that's cute, let me just put it together. So yeah, I got a new nail file. I finally got jumped in on the bandwagon on two products that have been like crazy when they came out. And I guess the craze isn't as much as it used to be, but I finally got into the Infallible Shadows from L'Oreal and the Maybelline Color Tattoos. Now for the Maybelline Color Tattoos, I bought myself two of them, and the colors that I got were Bad to the Bronze, And I'm so sure you guys have seen this multiple times, so I'm not gonna spend too much time on this. That's bad to the bronze. And the other color that I got was Pomegranate Punk. Is it focusing? Well, doesn't want seem to want to focus. So this is what it looks like. I think this is a beautiful, beautiful color. I cannot wait to use it. I have used the Bad to the Bronze already, and I really like it so far. I didn't experience any creasing with it. For my eyelids, it was really good. So far, I've enjoyed using it. And the Pomegranate Punk, I haven't used yet, but I love this color. I'm just looking at, you know, I'm looking for something to wear this with. I might do something with the Nude Tude palette and this color as a base. And for the Infallible eyeshadows, I had to get this one. This one is the Amber Rush. You guys already know what this looked like, I'm sure. And it's a beautiful rose gold kind of color. I've seen it on YouTube videos, I've seen it in pictures, but until I saw it on Melissa from 30 Plus Some, I didn't realize how freaking beautiful this thing is, and I saw it on her and I said, I just have to go get it. When I went to go get the Infallible eyeshadow, I actually was up in Nashville in CVS, and CVS actually had the new collection from L'Oreal, which I haven't found anywhere. I did see it mentioned at ThatGirlShaexo. She did a video about a week or two ago, you know, with them, and she said she got them at her Ulta. I believe it, she said at her Ulta, but I haven't been able to find it anywhere, and I finally found it at the CVS in Nashville, one of the CVS's in Nashville. And the colors that I bought, because they only had four colors came out. Three are new, one is the Golden Sage, and they have the Golden Sage there as a regular line. So I don't know why they came out with it as a spring, summer kind of color thing. But the two colors that I bought myself was the Gleaming Bronze. Let me show you without the reflection. Oh, this is so pretty. Gleaming Bronze. And this one is Gold Imperial. Sorry guys, I don't know why my camera doesn't want to focus today. I'm gonna open that up. Look at that gold. And I like, I've been looking for a gold like this, a gold that doesn't turn kind of like a bronze or brassy kind of gold. I wanted just a pure gold, and this seems to fit the bill, so I'm very excited to try this on. I have not tried any of these, any of the new ones on. I did try the Amber Rush because I had to do it. It just looked that good, so I had to do it. There's a pink one, and I can't remember what the pink one is called, that came out with the new collection, and it's looks really pretty from what I've seen in the video from ThatGirlShaexo, but I haven't, and I'll link the video below so you guys can see it, but I haven't seen it in person. I'm sure I'm gonna like it because lately I've been into a pink kick. I don't know what's going on. Another thing that I bought when I went to the CVS was the Jordana Best Lash Extreme Mascara. I haven't opened it yet because I still am using, where is it? Okay, I'm still using my Maybelline 1x1, so I haven't opened this one yet, but I'm almost done with it. I mean, it's getting drier and harder to put on, and you know, you can start telling that, you know, your texture is changing on your mascara, it's time to change it out. So I'm very excited to try this. I got this based on a recommendation, again, from Melissa from 30 Plus Some. She did a review, not a review, my favorites, I think it was, a video, and I remember her saying that this is like her favorite mascara ever. So I was just like, well, shoot, it's only $2.99, so why not? I'm gonna try this instead of buying something that's almost like almost $10, you know, from the regular brand. And I'm always on the look for the new mascara, the latest mascara that gives me the volume that I'm looking for, because I'm always looking for volume, not exactly length. So that's it for the CVS haul, like mini haul, and my major purchase. Oh, I did get another birthday gift, but it was kind of belated, so I didn't film it when I did my big birthday haul. And I finally got the beauty blender. Let's see, there we go. the beauty blender, and my mother got this for me actually, and this is how it looks like. You guys have seen it, I'm so sure, but this is like the cutest little thing. It's so tiny right now because it's dried, but I've already used it twice and I absolutely love it. I mean, this thing is amazing. I did not expect to like it as much as I do. So yes, thanks mom. I know you watch this video, so thank you very much mom. So that's it for my CVS haul and major ticket item and I guess a birthday present. Thank you everybody so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this and have a great day.